The removal of a cataractous lens in an infant requires a technique different from that used in adult cataract surgery. A closed system approach is generally preferable due to the reduced scleral rigidity of infant eyes. Meticulous removal of the lens and anterior vitreous is important because of the intense postoperative inflammation and marked healing response. The eye is dilated with 2.5% phenylephrine and 0.5% cyclopentolate approximately 45 minutes before surgery. An infant-sized wire speculum is positioned for retraction of the eyelids after the patient is prepped and draped. 6-0 silk sutures are passed under the insertion of the superior and inferior rectus muscles for traction. 2 conjunctival peritomies are performed superiorly 3 to 4 clock hours apart. Each peritomy extends approximately 3 millimeters in length with a relaxing incision at one end. At the posterior limbus, an incision is made into the anterior chamber just large enough to insert a 20-gauge instrument with an MVR or meringotomy blade. The nasal incision is made first, and a blunt beveled 20-gauge needle, which has been connected to an IV bottle of balanced salt solution, is inserted. After the anterior chamber is deepened, a second incision is made, and the anterior capsule incised at the same time. The vitrectomy instrument, in this case the occutome, is inserted into the eye. The vitrector is set up at an aspiration pressure of approximately 125 millimeters of mercury and a cutting speed of 120 cuts per minute. The anterior capsule and any loose cortex is removed using both the cutting and aspiration modes. If the pupil is small and unresponsive to mydriatics, it may be retracted during the procedure with the irrigation needle or an iris retractor. Occasionally, iris sphincterotomies or a sector iridectomy may be necessary. In this case, the nucleus and central cortex forming the lamellar cataract is removed as a single piece. If the cataract is due to a posterior lenticonus, there is almost always a defect in the central posterior capsule of the lens. In that situation, the central lens material is left undisturbed as long as possible or until all the peripheral cortex has been removed. To remove the peripheral cortex, aspiration is increased to at least 200 millimeters of mercury. Using only as much aspiration as is necessary, the peripheral cortex is engaged and pulled centrally where it is cut and removed. If the posterior capsule is disrupted at this time, aspiration is reduced to less than 100 millimeters of mercury and more cutting is used. Too much aspiration with little or no cutting in the presence of vitreous increases traction on the retina and the likelihood of a retinal detachment. If all of the cortex cannot be removed with the vitrectomy instrument at the temporal incision site, The vitrector is removed and a second irrigation line inserted. After the first irrigation needle is removed, the vitrector is inserted at the nasal site. To remove the posterior capsule and anterior vitreous, aspiration is decreased to 75 millimeters of mercury and the cutting speed increased to 240 or more cuts per minute. Aspiration is increased with the linear suction foot pedal to only as little as is necessary, up to the preset maximum. Great care is taken to remove as much posterior capsule and anterior vitreous as possible by direct visualization or with transcorneal fiber optic illumination. When the vitrectomy is completed, air is used to form the anterior chamber and to check for vitreous. We usually perform a peripheral iridectomy. The wound is checked for vitreous and closed with one or two interrupted 9-0 vicryl or 10-0 nylon sutures. The conjunctiva is closed with the same suture. The traction sutures are removed and subconjunctival antibiotics and steroids injected. Postoperative care includes a protective shield for 3 to 5 days and topical midriatics, antibiotics, and steroids tapered over 1 month. A contact lens is fit and amblyopia therapy started within 3 to 7 days after surgery.